Here are some frequently used status code in Web API project. First is 200. It means OK. Suppose you are searching for some data and you got that data properly. It means the purpose of the request is successful. That is why the status code is 200. 201. If you have added a new resource by using the HTTP POST method, then the status code of the response will be 201. 204. No content. If the status code for any response is 204, it means there is no content. And because it is from the family of 2XX, it means the purpose of the request is successful, but it is not returning any data to the client. Then we have 301. If you are having a 301 response from your server, it means the resource that you are looking for has moved permanently. 302. If the status code of the response is 302, then the resource has moved temporarily. 400. Bad request. The 4XX is from the client error. If you are having something 400, it means this is a bad request, and this bad request is because of the wrong data that we have sent in the HTTP request from client to the server. 401. Unauthorized. If you are looking for a resource that you do not have access, then in that situation you will get unauthorized error, and the status code for unauthorized is 401. 404. Not found. If you are looking for a resource that does not exist, then you will get 404. Suppose you are looking for a book with ID 102 and there is no record in the database with ID 102 against the book, then in that situation the server will return a response code 404. 405. Method not allowed. What are the methods? We have already discussed all the methods in the previous video. Get method, post method, put method, etc. If you use some other method in the request other than the actual method, then you will get this 405 status code. Let's say we have an web API that expect the get method. If you are calling that web API by using the post method or put method, then you will get the status code 405. Like this method that you are sending in the request, this method is not allowed on this particular web API. 500. Internal server error. If there is some exception in the server, then the status code will be 500. This exception may be because of any reason. Suppose the connection with the database is not working, then you might get the server error. Or there is some unhandled exception because of the code that we have written into our project. 503. Service unavailable. For example, the server is down for maintenance. Then in that scenario, the status code will be 503. Remember, we need to focus on all these concepts very carefully while working with the RESTful Web API.